Hello everyone, and thanks for joining me for today's episode of Healthytarian Living. On this episode, I will be sharing with you how to make an extremely easy, quick, and versatile, and of course nutrient-rich snack, treat, or dessert idea. It is going to be the Spirulina Superfood Squares. And even though all of the ingredients within these squares can be considered superfoods in their own right, the emphasis is on spirulina because this is an ingredient that usually isn't easy to incorporate into our daily diets. Spirulina is a blue-green algae that has an extremely powerful flavor or taste, and it isn't one that we would typically or commonly describe as being delicious. And so while it has an extreme nutrient and health benefits, which I'll share with you about in a moment, it is tricky to get it into some of our meals. And so that's where I'll be sharing with you really my favorite way that I do like to enjoy spirulina as part of my personal lifestyle, and that's these superfood squares. And to start off with, I will share with you the characteristics of this particular snack, dessert, or treat idea. These superfood squares are 100% plant-based, meaning there are no animal ingredients used, and so we can consider them vegan. There's no cooking or baking involved, and so we can consider this also a raw recipe. There are no grains or flours used, so it is naturally, therefore, gluten and wheat-free. It is also corn-free, peanut-free, and nut-free. So it is a great choice also for those suffering from nut allergies that are not commonly able to eat many of the healthy whole food raw vegan treats, sweets, or desserts. And the recipe is also extremely versatile. You can make it lower in energy or calories, or you can make it higher to meet your particular needs. And I will give you those tips as we move through our video today. And overall, the snack is extremely nutrient dense, high in many vital and valuable vitamins, minerals, phytonutrients, and antioxidants, so it enhances and helps our overall health and well-being. So first we are going to talk about the spirulina, and this is a blue-green algae that is naturally found in various parts of our world in the waters. Now, when it comes to spirulina, some people consider this a food and some people consider it a supplement. And my first recommendation here is if you ever do want to use spirulina, it is best to use it in its most natural form. Once it gets processed into various supplements, that takes us a step away from its most natural form. So spirulina typically comes as a raw or dried product, and typically it is a rich green powder. Now, this powder you can add to your smoothies easily or into various snacks or treats like the one we're doing today. What is nutritionally outstanding about spirulina is that it is one of the highest sources of protein on our planet, one of the most highly digestible forms of protein. So the content of protein in spirulina is cited anywhere from 60 to 90% of its calories come from protein. This depends on some of the sources, the way that it's been tested, and also whether it was in its dry or raw form. Other benefits also include that it is extremely high in vital vitamins, especially the B vitamins, various minerals, including very high in iron, also very high in phytonutrients and antioxidants. And this is one of the reasons why spirulina is so often linked to being beneficial for our immune system, preventing things like cancer or helping to, as part of a healthy treatment of cancer, also preventing various infections and helping even with things like candida. It's also been linked to having some positive benefits when it comes to any aspects of heart disease, such as helping with our cholesterol, making sure it's all regular, as well as even high blood pressure. So many actually other claims and links have been made. Some have been scientifically linked, some are more anecdotal. And so before you try spirulina, especially if this is your first time, it is generally speaking considered safe for everyone, unless you have a specific medical condition such as like a hyperthyroidism or a seafood allergy or iodine overload, etc. That may not be the right product then for you. Also, if you are on any medication, be sure to first check with your natural healthcare provider if this is something that should be included as part of your diet. And again, not so much because it's a supplement, but because it is a powerful medicinal food. And that's why we have to make sure we use it in smart ways. The other thing to consider about spirulina is where you get it from. You cannot go for just any source of spirulina from, you know, the cheapest one from any company. Before you purchase your spirulina or choose to use spirulina, you have to make sure you know and trust the source and where it's coming from on our planet, because it can build up the toxins that are now found more and more commonly in our waters all over the world. So making sure that you do your research and find a really high quality, reputable source is very, very important. Finally, even though it has some really incredible health and nutritional benefits, we always have to remember that it is not one food that is going to make it or break it for us, but the overall quality of our diet. So for those of you who are feeling called to try and use some spirulina as part of your diet, great. But if you're not, don't feel like you're missing out on something that you cannot absolutely get from other sources when you follow a high quality, whole food, plant-based lifestyle. And so when it comes to the spirulina, if you're starting out with this recipe, I recommend starting out with 2 tablespoons, maybe even 1 tablespoon if you want to make sure that, you know, it's really going to agree with you. And then working your way up to about 4 tablespoons. And today I use about 4 heaping tablespoons of spirulina powder when I make this recipe. Our next ingredient is raw cacao powder. And the emphasis here again is on raw cacao powder, not any baker's cacao powder, etc. And when it comes to raw cacao powder, outstanding source of course, antioxidants, one of the highest aspects of antioxidants out in nature. Extremely valuable phytonutrients are also found in raw cacao powder, as well as high in various vitamins and minerals, especially minerals like magnesium and iron. Raw cacao powder is also very high in protein. So in the end, you will notice that this snack is very high in protein and healthy fats. In terms of how much cacao powder to use, again, here you can play, and this is what I always recommend, play and make the recipe your own. So you can start off with anywhere like 4 heaping tablespoons of cacao powder, or about 1/2 cup to 1 cup. It all depends on how chocolatey you would like to make it. Another core ingredient of this recipe are hemp seeds or hemp hearts. Now, when it comes to hemp hearts, again, it is another extremely high plant source of protein and also healthy fats, especially the right omega-6 to omega-3 ratio of fatty acids, which is so vital in our society today. When it comes to the minerals, hemp seeds are also extremely high in so many vital minerals like our iron, like our magnesium, manganese, phosphorus, etc. In terms of how much you would be using for this recipe, at least 1 cup to 1.5 cups is what I recommend, and more likely closer to the 1.5 cups. Our next ingredient is unsweetened, unsulfured, organic dry coconut, shredded, flaked, etc. Now, when it comes to this ingredient, it is completely optional, and here's how you should use it in a smart way. If you are a very active or athletic individual, or someone who works out regularly and needs like a post-workout boost or perhaps if you're still growing in your teenage years, etc., or if you simply require more calories and energy, maybe trying to actually gain weight, then I would recommend using the coconut. If you are the opposite of everything of that, pretty much trying to lose weight, if you are not very active, more sedentary, then I would omit putting this in. So it's not going to make it or break it, but you can use this in a smart way to either to enhance the recipe and snack in ways that will work best for you. In terms of how much, you can sprinkle in anywhere from 2 to 4 tablespoons typically. Our next ingredient is you will need either some coconut oil or some coconut butter, and that's really up to you. For those of you who feel comfortable using coconut oil, as it is considered a superfood, you can go for the coconut oil. The coconut butter is the more whole food version, as the oils are always the extracts of the real or whole food. And so either way, coconuts have many benefits when it comes to being a source of extremely healthy medium chain triglycerides or healthy fats. And depending again, if you go for the more wholesome version like the coconut butter, then it will also include various vitamins, minerals, phytonutrients, antioxidants, etc. How much coconut butter or coconut oil? About 4 tablespoons, and you can make these more heaping or less heaping. The only difference it's going to make is whether your squares are a little bit harder or a little bit softer upon refrigeration. And finally, when it comes to our sweetener or last ingredient, you can use 1 of 2 ingredients. For a completely whole food sweetener, I recommend using medjool dates, not regular dates, but specifically medjool dates, or you can try raisins. Now, if you are okay with using honey, and it must be raw honey, or else it's really a dead sugar product for us. So with respect to the raw honey, you'd be using about 2 tablespoons. You can make them slightly flatter or more heaping, depending on how your taste bud levels are adjusted when it comes to sweetness. Now, for some people who are used to very high sweet sugar diets, the 2 tablespoons won't even be enough. But that's just enough to make it a really nice and pleasant sweet. Now, if you'd like to use the medjool dates, then I recommend about 6 or so medjool dates. Play around, and right before you take the mixture and press it into your dish, just be sure to taste it and keep in mind that the flavors will develop within 24 hours more strongly. So you will have actually a sweeter flavor the next day than when you taste it. In terms of the tools that you will need, it is, again, a very simple recipe and very quick and just requires some basic tools. So you're definitely going to need a measuring cup and some tablespoons to measure out the different quantities of the ingredients as we just talked about. It is also very helpful to have a spatula, and your final product should go into an 8x8 glass dish. You can use the nonstick ones, but it's always healthier to go with a glass dish. And we are also going to need a food processor. And this is what's going to be most important, of course, to make sure that we get all these ingredients to combine to make our squares. So let's put all of our ingredients and the appropriate quantities into our food processor. All you need to do then is blend away. And once you get the mixture to really make almost like a one clump, that's when you know you can stop the food processor. And so here's our mixture all done and ready to be pressed into our glass dish. A few key practical points. Once you start processing, if you stop it a few minutes into it, you may notice that it is very powdery or dry. Now, normally, if you keep letting the food processor spin, it will start to crumble, and you may even get one big clump depending what you're using, whether it's coconut oil or coconut butter, honey, or medjool dates, or it may start to form clumps. Either way, this is the stage that you want it to be at. Now, if you keep processing for a few minutes and it really doesn't seem like it's starting to clump at all, it may be just slightly too dry, again, depending on the choice of ingredients that you've used. So at that point, you can either increase something like the coconut butter or coconut oil or another medjool date or a little bit more honey, but you can just as easily add a tablespoon or 2 at most, but usually just 1 tablespoon of water. And that will usually just bind everything together very quickly. So at this stage, we have this beautiful dark mixture, and all we need to do is transfer it into our glass dish, press it down firmly with your spatula, and we are all done. And so this is what the pressed mixture would look like in your dish. Now at this point, you can cut it into squares right away and enjoy it in its soft version, or you can place it into the refrigerator and perhaps within 2 to 4 hours, you will get a nicer, harder square, and you can cut it into squares then and enjoy anytime. Note that these squares will keep exceptionally well, and you can store them in the refrigerator for days, even up to a few weeks, and or you can also freeze them and have them to enjoy whenever you may like. I commonly recommend to cut it into a 4x4 pattern and get 16 squares, and typically 1 square would be 1 serving. And as always, be sure to enjoy snacks like this mindfully, that we are not overdoing a good thing, because while it has so many exceptional nutritional and health benefits, we can of course overdo a good thing if we are not mindful about our choices. Thank you for joining me today, and until next time.